Running your business from a personal phone number works at the beginning, but as you grow, those missed calls start turning into missed revenue. I've used Quo, formerly OpenPhone, the AI-powered business tool for 2026 and beyond. Today, I'm going to show you how it helps you never miss another customer. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome to my channel, where I share practical tools to help you work smarter and build your brand. Today, we're talking all about Quo, the new name for OpenPhone. It's the same modern business phone system used by over 90,000 businesses and one that my audience already knows now with a bigger focus on AI and shared context. It's especially great for small teams, service-based businesses like home services, property management, legal teams, and anyone who can't afford to miss customer calls or lose track of client conversations. Quo is sponsoring this video, but as always, I'm going to show you the product exactly as I see it so you can decide if it fits for your business. We'll walk through how Quo brings calls, texts, and contacts into one place, how Sona, the AI agent, answers calls 24/7, and how teams stay aligned even when you're not at your desk. Let's start inside Quo so you can see what it would look like actually using this. First, let me show you what I think is Quo's biggest strength. You can see absolutely everything that's happening with a customer, calls, texts, and notes in one view. No more bouncing between apps or wondering who replied last. Here's the main Quo dashboard where your team lives day to day. And when I do these demos, I like to show it exactly how your account will look when you just get started. You can imagine how this is going to populate as you start to use it more. Now on the left, you've got your inboxes showing active conversations. This is where calls, texts, and voicemails all show up together instead of being split across different tools. Something I love, you see the full history. So things like missed calls, return calls, texts, voicemails, even any notes that my team has added. It reads like a familiar messaging app, but this is actually your business phone. Over on the right, Quo shows you the key contact details, name, number, any fields that you've added so teammates can see who they're talking to at a glance. And then on the right here, you get more context. You can add notes, even tags. Maybe here I'll add replacement requested, or check which team member handled the last touch point. This keeps everyone aligned, which matters when multiple people talk to the same customer. The main idea here is clarity. When someone calls or texts, you don't have to dig through phone logs or separate inboxes. You open Quo, click the thread, and instantly see what's happening so anyone on your team can step in and give the customer a smooth, consistent experience. Now, for the feature that set Quo apart, Sona, this is so good. This is their AI agent that answers calls when you can't. Think of it as a receptionist that works all hours, doesn't forget details, and always logs what happened. Let's jump into Sona's setup so you can see how this looks behind the scenes. I promise it's not that hard. Inside Quo, Sona lives directly inside your call flow along your regular routing steps. So here I'm opening the default support call flow for my main business line. At the top, you basically choose how calls are routed based on business hours. So during hours, calls can ring your team, and after hours, you can decide whether callers go to voicemail or Sona instead. That gives you control over when Sona steps in and how hands-on you want the AI to be. Now below, you'll see what happens when a call isn't picked up. If my team doesn't answer within the set time, Quo automatically moves the call to the next step in the flow. In this case, that's voicemail. Here I can customize the voicemail greeting, turn on transcription, and make sure every call is captured in text so nothing gets lost and no one has to listen to every recording manually. From here, that voicemail shows up directly in the shared inbox alongside calls and messages with a transcript and timestamp. Once this is set, calls are handled automatically. Either someone answers live or a message is captured and logged for follow-up. The goal is simple: fewer missed calls, clear next steps for the team so customers aren't left wondering if anyone saw their message. Now, let's look at what happened after Sona takes a call. Here's a real example of a call Sona handled outside business hours. This is what a caller hears when they call the support number and Sona answers in real time.
Hi, thanks for your call. Sorry, but we're closed right now. Please leave us a message and we'll get back to you as soon as we open. Thank you.
The caller would proceed to leave a voicemail. Once that call ends, everything shows up right here in the Quo inbox. At the top of the thread, Quo shows the call that was missed, when it came in, and that it was received outside of business hours along with the recording. And under that, you get the automatic transcript of the message. You can see quickly what the caller needed without listening to the full voicemail, but you can still play the recording if you want more detail. That can be helpful for complex requests when tone really matters. And just like any other thread, your team can jump in, reply by text, or call call the customer back directly from here. In this case, Quo even sent an automatic reply, letting the caller know that we received the message and we would follow up. Everything lives in the same shared inbox your team already uses: calls, messages, transcripts, and notes. So instead of listening to a bunch of voicemails, you can skim the transcript, understand the issue instantly, and know that the customer has already been acknowledged, making follow-up faster and smoother. Sona handles live calls, but Quo also uses AI to take care of small tasks that slow you down, like note-taking, tagging, or keeping conversations organized. Back in a customer thread, you can see an AI-generated call summary right away, pulling out the key details from the conversation. So things like what happened, what the customer needs, and what should happen next. Now, for longer calls, this summary is a huge time saver. You don't have to listen to the full recording or write everything down. The main details and action items are already here. Now, if someone from your team needs to jump in later, they can skim the summary or open the transcript, then pick up exactly where things left off without guessing. You can also add your own notes and at mention teammates so they can see the context immediately. It's a nice combination of AI handling the recap and humans adding judgment where it matters. And if you want help replying, Quo AI is built in right here for the conversation down here. I can use a simple command to ask Quo AI to draft a response based on the call summary and transcript. That gives you a solid starting point you can quickly review, tweak, and send without writing every message from scratch. This is useful if you're growing quickly or you have a lean team. You can spend less time hunting for details and more time actually serving customers. One of my favorite things about Quo is that it helps your team collaborate behind the scenes with customer message threads without the customer ever feeling the handoff. Quo is built for shared responsibility, not one person owning a phone. Let's take a quick look at how Quo scales with your team. And for this, I'll hop over to settings. There are two main ways to organize things as you grow. You can set up separate phone numbers by department, so say sales and support, each with its own inbox. I've got one for now for support, but I could easily see how this would expand if necessary. There's a second option. You can keep one shared number and organize your team into groups, routing calls behind the scenes without changing the customer experience. Remember, customers never see this internal coordination, both settings and threads inside the dashboard like we've looked at. And as your team grows, you can also manage everything from the members section. This is where you invite team members, assign roles, and decide who has access to which numbers or inboxes. By now, you should hopefully see how possible it is for customers to get a consistent experience, consistent replies, even as your team changes, and you don't have to rebuild your setup every time you hire someone new. Now, let's zoom out. I'll show you how Quo routes calls to the right person, how it connects to your other tools, and who I think gets the most value from this. We've already looked at the call flow itself, but this phone number has a few important settings worth calling out. From here, you can control things like business hours, call recording, and how much AI assistance you want layered in. If you want Quo to transcribe calls, generate summaries, or even automatically tag conversations — I don't have that enabled, but I could — you can just turn that on right here. If not, you don't have to. You'll also see auto replies, which send messages automatically when someone calls or texts. You saw that earlier, during business hours or after hours, so customers always hear back even if your team hasn't picked up yet. And if I scroll back to the edit mode for the call flow, again, this is where everything comes together. Every call follows the path. And by the way, you're not limited to just one flow. You can create different call flows for different situations, like holidays, when a team member is away, seasonal hours, or special campaigns, just a few examples. That way, your routing still works the way it should without you having to change anything manually. You don't have to forward calls, share personal numbers, or worry about missed calls when schedules change. Next, let's look at integrations and analytics. Quo connects with tools like HubSpot, Salesforce, Zapier, plus their own API. That means calls, texts, and key details can automatically sync in your CRM instead of relying on manual updates. On the analytics side, you can see call volume, response times, how different numbers or teammates are performing. That helps you find bottlenecks and decide where to add coverage and spot opportunities to coach your team and improve how conversations are handled. It also gives you a better view of peak times. If you see spikes every Monday morning or every time you launch a campaign, you can plan staffing accordingly. Taken together, shared inbox, Sona, AI summaries, call flows, and integrations, you get a phone system that feels built for modern teams, not something bolted on to an old setup. So that's Quo, formerly OpenPhone, an AI-powered business system that brings your calls, texts, and contacts into one shared space and adds Sona as a 24/7 AI receptionist so that you never miss a customer. If your team is still juggling calls on personal numbers and hopping between tools, this might be the moment to consolidate everything into one place. You can try Quo and Sona free for 7 days using the link in the description if you decide to stay. There are also three plans starting at just $15 per month, and it's easy to choose what fits your team. You can use my affiliate link, which supports the channel at no additional cost to you, and it gives you an easy way to test the platform with your own real workflows. Let me know in the comments what you think. How would you use an AI receptionist in your own business? I'll be reading and replying to your thoughts. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.